It happened less than 40 miles from Bailey, Colorado, the nation's most deadly school massacre at Columbine High. Craig Scott survived the rampage by two fellow students. His teenage sister did not. He knows better than most what happens when the cameras go away and the headlines fade. His life has been shaped by his horrifying experience in ways that he never expected. Sara James has more on the long journey back.
When I hear about these school shootings, it affects me. It usually gets me to think about what I went through, but it is definitely a possibility to heal down the road.
23-year-old Craig Scott knows more about healing than most people. It's now been more than 7 years since Craig lay frozen with fear on the library floor of Columbine High School as Eric Harris and Dylan Klebold gunned down student after student. It's now been more than 7 years since they murdered his sister Rachel.
I found out the next morning. It was confirmed that she was dead.
The nation first met Craig just 2 days after the massacre, speaking on the Today Show about his sister's death.
My sister was a real person. She was real to people. She really had a lot of ambition. And I loved her a lot.
Rachel was the first student to die in the shootings at Columbine. Fun-loving and adventurous, she was also known for her devout religious beliefs. Her private diaries, in which she wrote about the importance of kindness and compassion, were published after her death. Dateline followed Craig and his family for the first year after Rachel's murder, as they tried to cope with their immeasurable loss.
I didn't get to say goodbye to her physically. In fact, I didn't even say anything when she dropped me off at school that morning.
In public, Craig displayed courage as he traveled across the country to share his story and that of his sister with thousands of students. But privately, he was haunted by terrifying flashbacks, lying motionless on the library floor, listening to the last gasps of dying friends.
I was laying there next to him, and I couldn't get it out of my mind.
In the beginning, he found solace in his faith.
Every time I pray, if it's 10 seconds, It stops.
The images stop.
The sounds, too. The sounds were awful.
But soon, even prayer was no match for the terror, especially at night. On a handheld camera back in the spring of 2000, Craig chronicled his desperate attempts to escape the nightmares.
I am up here on the top of my roof.
Racked by survivor's guilt, he returned to the spot where his sister died to apologize for not being able to save her.
Please forgive me. I just still have a lot of anger.
The lowest point came after our cameras left, about a year and a half after Rachel's death. Craig and his younger brother, Michael, were watching a movie on TV when a particularly violent scene triggered a flashback. What followed haunts Craig to this day.
My brother, who had no idea what I was going through, was just watching TV, and then I turned to him and I said, change the channel. And he said, why? And I snapped. And the next thing I knew, I'd picked up my brother, my little brother, who I love. I carried him to the kitchen. I slammed him against the kitchen floor. I pulled out a knife, I put it in front of his face, and I said, do you want to know what it feels like to almost lose your life?
It was a pivotal moment, a turning point. Craig realized that if he didn't let go of his anger, he might never recover. His first step, to forgive Rachel's killers.
Forgiveness was like setting a prisoner free and then finding out that prisoner is you. Being angry is definitely part of the process of losing someone to violence. But it's what you do with that anger that's going to decide who you become and who you are later down the road.
Craig says chronicling his own dark days on tape sparked an interest in filmmaking. And after he graduated from Columbine in 2002, he enrolled in a Denver film school.
I really want to make films that build people up, that inspire people, that tell stories of ennobling characters.
This actually was a class project that she did.
One of his upcoming projects, to bring the story of his sister's life and faith and the impact of her death to the big screen. He continues to speak publicly through Rachel's Challenge, an organization founded by his father to combat school violence.
I have to keep doing what I'm doing. This speaking is so important. Keep sharing the story, even though I get tired of sharing it sometimes.
For Craig, keeping the memory of his sister Rachel alive is more than a mission. It's his salvation. He once dreamed of finding his way back to the boy he was before the shooting. But part of his healing was the realization that that could never happen.
Columbine was the worst day of my life. But now looking back, I can be almost thankful in a way for going through such a hard thing, because it's made me who I am today.
Deadly violence in schools is a continuing problem in this nation. Since 1996, at least 70 people have died in approximately 30 school shootings. For more on the recent killings and to learn more about how you can talk to your kids about school violence, log on to our website. The address is dateline.msnbc.com.